influence diagram. When doing decision tree analysis becomes complicated because it requires probability, impacts, and calculation, sometimes we want to just show the relationship between various elements of our project to the stakeholders so that they can understand the criticalness of some of the risks. In order to do that, we can prepare an influence diagram. You can visualize it that various elements of the project I can show in the format of circles. So maybe I have many circles, and then I show arrow line if one aspect is impacting other. So there is a possibility one aspect might be impacting other three elements. So I will be showing that this is influencing these three elements. Now by visualizing it, if there is a one element which is impacting other elements, I understand this element is pretty critical. And there is also a possible understanding if there is a one type of element which may be getting influenced by many. Then you also know that this thing may get delayed because anything out of these things goes wrong, it can impact this particular aspect of our project. You can consider it more like a presentation tool, more like making people realize the overall picture of risk and its impact on various aspects of the project. From a PMP exam perspective, just knowing the word influence diagram, and you know that it helps you in understanding how one element influences others and can be used as a tool for presenting the results of quantitative risk assessment, is good enough for your exam.